something nice just happened to them or something. Yeah, so they look really nice. Thank you. supremacists. Where, you know, they thought their race was much better than everyone else's. So essentially, they were pretty much the Nazis. These high elves. So we can just kind of go with that idea, I guess. My very good friend Daniel says high elves are Nazis. it's meant to be hard, but we can find ways to overcome it by maximizing our meaning in life. So if you feel stuck right now, I'll just doodle while I keep talking. So if you feel stuck in life right now, maybe it's because you haven't found your meaning. Maybe you've just been doing what you're supposed to be doing, as told by someone else in your life, like a parent or a mentor. Like, don't get me wrong. People should be responsible. They should have goals. They should achieve things and, you know, attempt to achieve things. But still, sometimes you don't even realize you're living your life for someone else or for someone else's expectations. It's set up, you know, like a structure that you can follow, get a job, go to school, blah blah blah, all of that. That's a safe, low risk, low reward life that you can always fall back on. But then if you want to step outside of that little, if you want to step outside of that little society where you're like, no, it just doesn't feel right. I don't think I will be doing this type of life. It just doesn't seem like the right life for me. It's chaotic. If you leave that, I'm getting a lot of this from Dr. Jordan Peterson, who's like, I feel like he's my stepdad, even though I've never met him in my entire life. I've just watched so much of his videos, and he's so damn freaking awesome. Anyway, so he says, if you want to, you know, remove yourself from society and go down your own path and, you know, make your own life, which he's not saying you shouldn't do that. He says that if you do that instead of following a more structured societal life that's set in stone and a lot easier to follow, if you step outside of that, will be chaotic, because that's new territory. You know, it's no one's been there before you. To just let you know for sure that it's gonna pay off, or the risk is much higher. And you know, honestly, the reward is higher too, because I can only talk about myself, so I'll just use myself as an example. So, like right now, I'm not making a damn thing on YouTube, and that's to be expected, because my channel's only 2 months old, and I just don't have the following or anything like that, and it's not even like, it's not even the end goal. It's just accrue a bunch of money. It's to somehow generate income, okay? Because when your parents get on your ass about freaking getting a job, or anyone in your life, say, get a job, get a job, get a job, get a job. Shut them up in your brain. Okay? Because they're just societal talking points that have done nothing but follow society. And there's nothing wrong with that. But what they really mean is they want you to get an income. Okay? I want you to try and tell me the difference between a job and an income. Because the reason you're working, usually, is for an income. Even if you're a doctor, even if it's something, you know, really, really passionate and stuff like that. I've worked with many doctors. They're 100% there for the money. And if they don't get the money, they pitch a fit, okay? So lots of people like to imagine doctors as these selfless people that absolutely would be a doctor if they were paid $5 an hour. That is not the case. They like going to school because they know it's going to pay off. They're able to put in thousands and thousands of hours, days of work to achieve like a medical degree. They know that level of dedication to something needs to be rewarded appropriately, and I agree. Like, I don't think a doctor should be paid minimum wage. I'm not saying that at all. I'm just saying that the point is when people want you to get a job, just remember, they want you to get an income, okay? So that's what I had to separate myself from, because to come along with it. It's a bonus. There's nothing wrong with creating things for other people to enjoy. That is a very, very noble field. Entertainment, artists. I mean, the music industry itself is humans love to treat themselves, you know? Like, why would we not just eat rice and beans every single day? Like, why do we want the new flavors, new textures, new experiences, new... We're just constantly, like, searching for things that'll entertain us. You know, like, it's just, we really hold ourselves high in terms of the animal kingdom, to the point where we feel ourselves, because we're very intelligent. Well, let me rephrase that. It's because we have larger brains. And we feel that we need to be, that we deserve entertainment. But, yeah, I'm kind of getting off topic. So, yeah, there's nothing at all wrong with if this brings you happiness. Scary, because people judge your worth on whether you have an income or not, or like how much you make, or like, you know, how people will look down at minimum wage people. It's just ridiculous. The people that are in line at McDonald's will look down on the workers. Does that make any sense to you? Like, they drove their drunk asses to McDonald's, and they have the gall to make fun of the employees that work there. I'm sorry, I'm getting a little loud. town, because this gets me a little emotional, but they drove to McDonald's. Okay, they demanded the service from McDonald's, and then they still had the gall to talk crap about minimum wage workers. Like, you would not be eating that food if some guy just... Someone actually got up. Someone decided to put on their uniform. Someone decided that, okay, I guess I will go to McDonald's today. And here you are, talking absolute crap about them, stuffing your face with McDonald's. And you've got the nerve. You've got the freaking nerve. That's why I hate money sometimes, because you're worth... Your worth is instantly gauged by your income. That's just how our society works. That's why jobs like engineers and doctors and stuff, they're more revered. That's the word. And you know, and I'm not trying to simplify those positions. I'm not trying to simplify those occupations whatsoever. Be a doctor or an engineer, they require lots of work. Lots of work. People that are doctors and engineers aren't lazy, okay? I mean, there's lazy doctors, but they're not lazy in med school, okay? You can't be lazy in med school, and you can't be lazy in, you know, engineering school. Is that a thing? I don't know. But yeah, of course it is. Those type of people have a drive as well. Trying to knock doctors in STEM positions, you know. So, but your worth, and it's very simple. To yourself. And that type of talk, it would get to anybody. Okay? It would get to anybody. I mean, look at all the celebrities that make millions and millions and billions and billions, and they, you know, like, they have their meltdowns too. Okay? Things get to people. The more you hear it, the more likely it's gonna get to you, because you're just like, wow, I just keep hearing this type of talk. It must be true. I must be a piece of crap because I work at McDonald's, or and I just, and it's like, there's nothing wrong with working at McDonald's, and especially if you're it's, you know, it's 2 or 1 in the morning. You're drunk out of your mind, you've been having a good time with your friends, and everyone's like, oh my gosh, I'm hungry, I want to go eat something. What's one of the first choices? It's McDonald's, okay? You go there when you're smashed. And what a fantastic service. Don't even get me started on them being unhealthy. Of course they're unhealthy. You're not supposed to eat there every day. You're not supposed to eat there every day. You're not even supposed to eat there probably twice a week. It's just a once in a while type of thing. But imagine this, if that wasn't available. Imagine hungry, drunk people just starving themselves. There's no McDonald's. Like, I mean, just see the worth in people. Let me just, I'm not going to whisper that. I'm just going to say it. See the worth in people. Like, actually really take your time to look at your at their worth. Don't just look at them in a surface level. Don't look at their skin color. Don't look at their occupation or their annual income. Don't do that. Like, seriously, get to know people. Really get to know them. See them. See them for who they really are. So that we get rid of this whole mentality of, oh, if you're poor, oh, if you're not making money, oh, if you're not raking in thousands and thousands of dollars every month, you're worthless. That's just pathetic. How does millions and millions of years of evolution of a human race, right? Okay, so I mean, we all came from microorganisms in the ocean. Crap, I'm not even gonna get started, okay? So you can just go open a freaking science book. Like, we all started as single cell organisms from the ocean, and eventually, you know, evolved into fish, evolved into primates. I mean, like, our primates, I said primates, primates, and then it's just, and then now all we do is we're obsessed about a currency invented by our species. It's not real, okay? The value is not real. The value of money is only there because of us. And I'm not trying to say we should live in an existence without money, because if you take money away, 100% something else will become currency. Because humans are greedy, and not only are they greedy, but they're narcissistic. They feel like they should be rewarded for stuff. They don't want to just do things. And I'm not saying, like, you're wrong if you have that mentality. That's a very human reaction to things. But it's not the answer for everybody. Videos are not boring, they're extremely relaxing, they're skin. Subscribe. You already know better, okay? And share it if you really enjoyed it. Okay. Thank you so much for sticking around to the end. We'll see you next time in the next video.